Freshman campus teacher Sasha Dajanowski is here with us, and he's talking to the community and parents about the basics of a Mac computer and how it works, how to save a document, where things are located, so we can have a better understanding of how these computers work.
Sasha's going to do a brief presentation about some of the things that we're doing at School City with our kids and our Macs, and then we're going to answer questions for you, and feel free to sit down at a Mac, hands-on. We'll help you get logged into the network here, and we can answer questions for you. I know you, for instance, had a question about moving things to the recycle bin, so we'll get some of your questions answered as well. We also know that the library is going to invest some time and some resources into getting some Macs into this building, and we want to get parents in, and we'd like to have our parents utilizing these for things like access to our student information system, which is called RDS, so they can find out more information about their students if they don't have internet access at home, as well as just get a handle on what are my kids doing and what are my kids doing in the classroom. So with that, let Sasha take over.
Okay, well, like Mary said, my name is Sasha Dajanowski. You guys can call me Sash. Don't worry about the last name. There's no quiz or anything afterwards. Yeah, I work for School City Chicago. I've had the honor to come here and present before you guys, and it's going to be very informal. It's actually why I really dressed down from everything, because I figured, you know, I could sit up here and, like, you know, do all these things, have this, you know, blowout presentation for you, but I was like, what's the point? You don't want to hear me talk. You'd rather work. You know what I'm saying? So we're just going to party together. So I'm going to go ahead and take my computer off of the hiding monitor dual, and we'll go directly onto my monitor now. And guys, just follow along with me or just watch, whatever you prefer, okay? So as of right now, you guys are looking at the exact same thing that I'm looking at, okay? So this is just known as, you know, our docking station, or just, you know, our basically where you do everything, okay? The dock is actually down here. The reason why they call it dock is because you have all your documents down here. So pretty much all these little icons. We're gonna just play with the iLife suite, which is gonna be composed of iMovie, GarageBand. I was gonna do some iTunes stuff with you guys, but we don't have, we've got access to some things, but I think I'm just gonna leave that out. So we're just gonna do some simple stuff. So if you guys don't mind, just click on iPhoto with me. And if you don't know what that looks like, I'm gonna zoom in on it. This is what iPhoto is. It's this icon right here. So I'm gonna get out of your way a little bit. Just click on that and you'll see it bounce. And we'll just go from there.
Now, why does my thing say non-notification with network time?
It's because we're not connected to a network, so what we want to do is. Mary, is it the ECPL East one? Is that what we want?
Yes.
Okay.
Robert said it's ECPL East is our best wireless connection here.
So we just click on it and join.
You'll
be right in. So you want the photo? That's cool too. So on iPhoto, I'm just going to show you a couple of things on mine. And I'll take you guys through Photo Booth as well, because I just saw the Reverend went there. Photo Booth's pretty cool because it stores all your images, okay? So anything like off your cameras or your phones or anything like that, just dump right in here on iPhoto, okay?
Can I ask you something real quick?
Yes, absolutely.
I had a box that just came up and it said a new version of iPhoto is available as part of life.
Of the iLife suite.
So cancel.
Just cancel?
Yeah, we'll update later. Yeah.
Okay, so is it just like the regular stuff that comes up that
see,
be
you're
very
on,
careful?
Because
and don't.
You're on your own Mac. Okay. They're not quite set up as the way our school cities are. Why don't
okay.
I bring you one of ours
okay.
and have you do that? Since
perfect.
So a friend of mine, he had gone to Europe and he had taken a bunch of photos. So I plan on using these in my class when I talked about certain things. Like, you know, I've got like the Globe Theater over here and things. Well, in iPhoto, it pretty much just takes your photos and you can group them and block them however you want. And for those of you guys that are new to Macs, don't be afraid. I would just be honest with you. I know that sounds weird because a lot of people are like, I don't want to use a Mac, I don't know what to do. You know, it's the exact same thing, except you have one mouse, you have one click. It's not the end of the world. Trust me, you'll get around it. You know, it's very easy to manipulate. So, and the other thing I'll tell you is whatever you think the machine should do, go with that feeling and do those things, okay, when you're using these. Because a lot of people are like, I don't know what to do next. Just go with what you feel the machine should do next for you. So I want to go ahead and do some stuff with these photos. So if I go to File, I can go to New, and I can create an album. And in that album, basically, I can take all photos that I want on my library. If I want to make a photo album of my child or my wife or us doing stuff, something on a vacation, I can take all those photos, dump them in there, make an album. Or If I want, I can make a smart album, which gives me the opportunity to do other types of things, like make a photo album that I can actually have printed somewhere. I can actually go ahead and have that sent out somewhere, or a CD or anything along that line. But what I'll do is I'm going to do something very quick, painless, and easy. You see this button down here that says slideshow? I'm just going to zoom in on it. Okay, for this case, I'm just going to take all these photos. I'm going to make a quick slideshow. It's going to be painless. I'm going to click play. And automatically, it'll now just take everything and it'll create a new slideshow. And it tells me I have themes here. And if I go ahead and I kind of look over them, oh look, I have all these different things. I like origami, we're gonna go with that. That's what I want. So all my photos are gonna come up in this weird, different way that's gonna be presented. I'll go to music. It gives me songs that are already on here for these presentations. I'm gonna go with City Livin', which is the G11 Special Sauce song. Just go from there. And then I've got other things in here in settings, nothing too rough. So now that I've got everything set the way I want, oh, sorry, am I talking too fast? Sorry, Mary.
Too fast.
I lost, I lost.
I'm sorry.
I don't even have.
Let's go back to the beginning.
Well, I kind of thought they don't have any photos on there, so I thought I would just kind of whip through this so then they could play. That was my whole point, because I figured I only have photos, but I'll slow down. Sorry, guys.
Okay, I have different squares.
I've been teaching mode, I apologize.
I have different squares.
You have different squares?
Did I not do something yet?
She just has the welcome screen.
The welcome screen?
I have the welcome.
Yeah, it was closed. We'll walk you through there.
Okay, cool. If it's just the welcome screen, it's just telling you the beauty of this is that it'll let you go through an internet tutorial, which is kind of nice. And I'm sorry that I was talking fast. At any point in time, if you feel like, hey, slow down, hey, go back to that, honestly, it's no big deal. Just let me know. I apologize. Again, I've been like going at it all day. So if that happens, it's kind of beautiful about this as well is that the internet's already set up with these little 1 minute or 2 minute intros into any programs for you to do. So you also have tutorials at all times for any of these programs. So that's kind of nice. Do you guys want me to show you this or no? It's up to you. I can go back some. Just show you? All right. I'll just hit play. It's pretty much manipulating the photos into anything. You know, that's just something I just set up with a couple of clicks, okay? Now, you have the option to do this as well with your own photos. And the nice thing is once you build this photo album, and I know I went really quick through that and I apologize. Once you do this with your own photos, you just kind of set them up however you want in whatever order, you can click on slideshow and you can actually save this slideshow. And you can have this as a DVD or whatever you want. You send this to family members, post it on your Facebook page, whatever you want to do. So that's kind of the beauty of this is that it's a three-button step. And I apologize, I went real quick through, and I can do it again because I want to take a break right now after this, and I just want you guys to play in iPhoto for a little bit. So I'm just going to stop that. So you saw that was just a really quick setup. If you guys want, we can play in iPhoto and come around, just hang out with you guys for a little bit. We can move on, whatever you want to do. You guys tell me. You want to go through docs?
Yeah, I think we know we need to go through the doc and explain what is there and available and do some basic applications with it, opening up Safari,
sure.
Things of that nature.
Not a problem. Okay, so earlier we talked about the doc being this station down here that has all of your icons, which basically are all the things that your computer can do.
If you think about a Windows machine, because a lot of you are very familiar with that, it's your desktop. Apple merely does not like to see the desktop cluttered, so they put them all down at the bottom and call it the docking station. So it really is like the Windows desktop. They just happen to be in a different location.
Safari is just like Internet Explorer. So it's the exact same thing. It is called Safari.
Safari, Firefox, Google Chrome, they're all simply a way to access the Internet. And it happens to be the default browser, that Apple utilizes.
Another thing I'll show you guys is there's this magnifying glass in the upper right hand corner. Okay, on this magnifying glass, if you click on it, it tells you spotlight search. So if you have something on here that you wanted to look up or you can't find something that you wanted, like let's say for example PowerPoint, you just type it in and it'll look for it for you. So that's kind of nice, is that you don't necessarily have to go into your control panel for those of you guys that are used to using PCs or anything along that line.
So if you're looking for a program, and Sasha just showed you, it's not on the dock. You've looked for it. You want to use PowerPoint. It's an Office product as part of Office 2011 that we have loaded on these particular machines. As you said, you can search for it, and it will show up. So for instance, if you were looking for Word or something else that wasn't on the dock, or maybe it's Outlook, it would again appear up in that area. So you could search for programs there.
Any questions right now or anything? Is there anything you guys want to move into? You just want me to keep going through a couple more of the...
Go through some more applications on the dock.
Sure. Do you want me to do iPhoto Booth?
Well, I think we could, yes. Let's open up Photo Booth.
Sure.
And show people that this is a way...
So Photo Booth looks like this, literally like a little photo booth-y, old photo booth that you could actually like put in a couple, like a dollar in quarters and get like a snapshot of like 4 or 5 photos, things like that with your friends. So just click on Photo Booth and you'll see it bounce around and voila, there's you. Well, there's me. I'm looking at myself. That's interesting. So you've got options here. If you want, you can click the photo button, which is that red little icon. To take a snap a photo of you. It'll give you a countdown of 3, 2, 1. Knock yourself out.
Take your picture.
Yes.
Take your picture.
I hear the beepings already for some of you.
So think about a lot of new applications utilize pictures. If you have a Twitter account, even if you have an email address now, it actually can, you can add your own profile picture. So instead of taking a picture with a digital camera and then uploading it from your SIM card, you can utilize Photo Booth. Take a picture of me. Make sure it's flattering, and then you can use that as your profile picture.
You can also do a 4-shot, which just like we talked about the old Photo Booth, where you can time it, and then you can do different still shots of yourself. So here's one of me talking. So.
Well, and our kids love doing this, especially sometimes our kids with disabilities who are working on social skills and some of their emotional development. You know, make an angry face, make a happy face, show me what you look like when you're sad. And they can then actually see what they look like, because often they have trouble with those emotions.
So,
yes. Okay, from here, once I take a picture, how can I put that on Facebook?
Well, that's not something that we actually have the students do, but I'm sure Sasha will be happy to assist you with that. One of the other things we talk about in our school buildings is something called the Child Internet Protection Act. Facebook is something that we purposefully block. Facebook is notorious, unfortunately, for bullying, as well as for other types of just cyber aggression. So anything that involves social networking that is not completely monitored. We do have one classroom at the high school that is utilizing Twitter for some educational activities. But again, because of the Child Internet Protection Act, as well as the fact that we really want to protect our students from cyberbullying, we don't use that. But Sasha will show you how to do that.
I have another question. It says email. How do you put that to an email account?
Okay. It's real easy. Okay, so that photo that I double-clicked on, when you're talking about the email button,
Right. All
it basically will do is whatever email that is registered on this computer, once you click on email, it's gonna take that photo, just dump it in. Literally just does it for you. Just drags it right in and you send that photo on its way to whoever. But because these are going to be the public library computers, if you wanna post these on Facebook or your own email, you'd do it just the standard way that you would.
You'd save the picture, and Sasha will show you how to save it. And at that point, you can open up whatever email you choose to use. If you use a Yahoo account or a Gmail account, or Yahoo, Gmail,
AOL.
If you use one of the other accounts, you can then open it, and then you can simply attach it as a file. You can browse for it on the computer, select it. So when you save it, you want to give it a very specific name. You want to call it My Facebook Picture or whatever you choose to. So when you go to look for it, you say, is that the one I want? And you know exactly that it's the right file. And then you can simply attach it to your email account or to an email.
Technically, no. Picture's already saved. All you gotta do is, I'm gonna click. I'm gonna take this finger and just, you can follow along with me if you want. Just take your one finger, I don't care which finger you use, with your favorite finger. Just click down, okay? Click on that photo, make sure you're holding down on it, okay? Now take another finger. Any finger you want, second favorite finger. Pull it off, okay? Now, what you'll see on mine is that as I pulled it off, you see how it's dragging in La La Land? If I want, I can just drop this on my desktop. So there's my photo. If I want, I can take it directly to iPhoto and dump it right in there, and it's gonna dump it directly in my archive of photos now in iPhoto.
Did everyone see how we dropped that into another program?
So,
yeah.
There is no, like, that's the shortcut. Like, that's why I said, it, whatever you would like the computer to do, think in that fashion with the MacBooks or with the iMac, the desktop. Is okay, well, all I really want this to do, I just want to drag it somewhere and dump it. Then do that. I mean, that's the way that I would put it. That was why I said that initially. It's just, if that's what you feel that it should do, then try that, and it should do that. So they tried to make these as people-friendly as possible. And with the library getting, I assume these are going to be the new ones, they're going to have the new Lion operating system on them. They are basically making computers to the point now that if you have never touched a piece of technology before in your life, it literally will do everything for you. Like, you don't even have to save documents anymore on Lion. And that's scary.
What is Lion?
Lion is the new, like, operating system. Mac likes to name all of its operating systems what functions the computer has after animals. So Lion is the new one that they have coming out right now that they have. So. Yeah, I mean, you literally, like, on mine, I updated my computer at home. I have a Mac. I don't save documents anymore. It's weird, you know, because I still do it by nature, but I don't have to. So I'm saying you guys are going to have those luxuries with using the computers here. So that's exactly how you can just take that directly to Facebook. Is you've got it saved on there, just dump it in. Yes, sir.
Why is it not going to have, why are you not going to have to save it?
It'll automatically, they created the operating system for whatever programs you're using. It saves them. Just automatically save them for you. Yes.
Automatically.
It'll save them actually in a, it's called a launch pad on the computer, and they have this folder of stuff where you actually go in and they would just have your stuff. So let's say you have a document that you're writing a paper on, okay? Now you use that document, you write it, okay? But now you come back the next day and you want to update something, or you just want to steal something from that and create a new document, you can do that, and it'll actually still save that document the way it is and create another one for you. It's weird. I mean, because, yeah.
You work on both of them at the same time.
Exactly.
Mm-hmm.
And it'll even ask you, do you want to make this the new one or do you want to make it an alias? I mean, it's just, it freaks me out. I'm not going to lie to you because I'm like, no, I need to save this differently. What? And it's like, I don't have to.
Okay. If I'm working on a document,
mm-hmm.
and I'm used to, I guess, with the PC or Word, but I'm now doing it in Mac, what am I trying to say? And I'm trying to send it to somebody or something and it's not compatible. What do I have to do to make, because I don't want to, if I send it to you and when you get it, it's not the same, it's mm-hmm. out of sorts, so to speak. What do I have to do to make sure that when I send it to you, if I'm on a Mac and you're on a regular PC, that you get it exactly, the text and everything the same way? What do I have to do?
What I usually do is, I work in Microsoft Word mm-hmm. on a Mac, or if I work in Pages, which is the Mac program of Microsoft Word, I'll just do a file save as, and you can redirect the way you save it. And you can make it compatible for a Microsoft Word document.
How do you do that?
Or you can make it a PDF document. And Adobe, it's shown this, Adobe is the pretty much universal language of files. Adobe PDF is a free product that anyone can download. So if they don't have access to Microsoft Word, or they don't have access to Pages, they can actually bring Adobe free from the internet onto their machine. And if you save a document as a PDF and send it to them, that Adobe Viewer will allow them to look at it.
In the same way that
that's
I said
correct.
It will be
yes.
messed up and all.
That's correct. There are no challenges with that if you work with an Adobe
how
format
do you,
like
can
that.
You show me how to do that?
We'll show you how to do an Adobe. We'll show you how to save a file as a PDF.
Sure.
And then we can show you through Safari where you can find the Adobe Viewer.
Mm-hmm. Well, wouldn't an Adobe file be larger in size than a regular?
Not necessarily. And again, it depends on what you're sending. If you're sending someone, you know, extremely large files, you know, you may have some challenges anyway, depending on what the file sizes are that they can accept at the other end. So, but in general, Adobe is usually that universal language that everybody can read.
Yeah.
Cheryl, the file's meant to be edited, though. If somebody
that
wants
is a challenge.
To edit.
Correct.
That's what he was saying. When you do a file save as, choose a version of Microsoft Word, probably 2003 or lower,
and you pretty much be covered to anyone you'd send that to.
Yes, I don't need to know how to do that.
Because if they have Word, they'll be able to view it. Again, if they don't have Word, you're going to need to use Adobe.
Yeah. I'll show you how to create the portable document folder, the PDF, like Mary said. It's very easy, just sort of file. And this is actually, this is a paper that I'm working on for one of my classes. So I'm using exactly something right here that I have. So you can see I have a whole document. Okay? And I do this for my professor, actually, when he wants me to email this thing. Instead of copying and pasting it in Microsoft Word, I just save it as a PDF and ship it to him. So I just go to File, Print. Now you're wondering, why in the world would you go to Print? We're not printing anything. You're right. But down here, it says PDF in the corner. And just click there, and it says what your options are. Open as a PDF and preview. I want to save it as a PDF. And that's all I do. And now it gives me the options here. Just as an FYI, if some of you guys are following along with me, yours may look like this, right? If you guys are, if that's the case, it's shrunk everything. It's making it like a very minuscule detail of everything. If you want to enlarge that, you can actually see everything else that encompasses where you can send this file.
Well, what program are you in?
I'm in Pages.
And that would be Word?
This is an Inkwell right down here. Pages is this Inkwell.
Oh.
I just went directly to a file just to try to show you guys.
Okay, yeah. That would be still mature. I have Word on my doc, on mine, so that would be the same thing.
Same.
To save it as a PDF file? Or are you talking about Pages is the same as Word?
Pages. What is the Pages the same as Word?
It is. It's the exact same. Yeah. It's just Mac's version of doing Microsoft Word. So this is what I would do. I just would create this file, whatever name I want, as a save as, and I have the options of where I want to save it. It's telling me documents right now. I can choose documents. I personally like to save PDFs on my desktop so that I'm not looking for them and I know they're different. That's just me, though. Yes, sir.
How would you go about setting up a
booklet?
I need to create a six-page booklet.
Okay.
I got stuck on a couple days.
No problem. If you, would you want to use Word or you want to use Pages to do it?
Pages, I have stuff, I work on it.
No problem. New from template chooser, okay? Now, I'm showing some stuff in Pages about like how you can choose and you work on different documents. This is going to be the screen that you see when you go into Pages, all right? And now, if you look here where it says Word Processing, it's got options for you. Like, if I got to write a resume letter, the beauty is I just click on the letter button, which is right here, okay? If I'm going too fast, let me know, guys, because I know I was speeding through last time. You know, whatever you want me to do.
Does anybody need to know or catch up to where we're at here?
You're in Pages.
Yes. Yes, I am.
And what did you click on Pages?
I just clicked on New Template Chooser because I was already in a document.
Okay. It's not under.
Give me 1 second. Just let me check yourself. Sure. Okay.
Just keep asking.
So we go to File.
Oh, File.
New template chooser.
Oh, okay.
Yep.
I was looking
no
at the
problem.
Okay.
No worries. Okay. So,
and
I'm getting right to your thing. I don't want you to think I'm dancing. I'm just. So, yeah. So, like, it gives me options here if I want to write letters. Like, I can choose whatever type of letter I want. If I have to write a resume letter, they have those options already in here built. All you got to do is dump in your information. That's awesome. Same thing with the envelopes that go with it. Some sort of form that you have to do. What you're talking about is you've got a booklet you need to do, right? Basically a report.
Running back.
Yeah.
That gives you that's
just go to the reports option. And you can see here they have all these different types of reports where, you know, you have a visual report where that means, okay, you may have a lot of photos on things, okay?
You would be able to insert pictures.
Exactly. And to be honest with you, on any Pages document you do, inserting pictures is easy because all you do is dump them in.
Right.
But I am going to go to the visual report for you. I just want to show you some stuff. Is that cool?
Yeah.
All right. Yeah. I just went over here. I clicked on reports, and I'm going to go to the visual report for anybody that's following along with me. Bless you, Louis. So I'm just going to double click on that.
Is it under V?
So every window has
Is this alphabetical?
Nope. It's just here by topic. So I just went to reports, and then there's the visual one. Okay, now, so we have this here. This is just our first page, and the nice thing is that it's going to show you, okay, here's a couple of pages. It just sets these up for you, okay? I've heard it's Latin. I assumed it was gibberish that they just put some stuff in here. And a lot of people freak out because they're like, okay, now what do I do? Because I have all this writing in here. Well, just click on it. You see how it's all highlighted? Well, this says my favorite castles. Well, I'm going to change this to my favorite report, and which I misspelled. Okay? That's all you have to do, just point and click.
So you click on it and automatically highlights.
Yeah.
And then
you just dump in what you want. And, you know, same thing with all this information. It's very easy to get in there. Now, I know one thing you might be wondering is, okay, you've got a couple of pages on here that pictures, but how am I going to repeat this? Just go up here to where it says sections. Okay? Now, I'm going to zoom out so that you can see everything. It gives you options here on, okay, well, what type of pages do you want to add? And it has a layout already done for you for everything.
Where'd you find that again?
In sections. It's right up here.
Thank you.
No problem. So that's exactly how you can add in more pages of stuff. And then you can start customizing everything. Like the photos, just click on the photo. You see how I got the photo highlighted? I already have pictures on this computer, which I do because this is, you know, the one that I work on. You have these three buttons up here that are kind of like your lifesavers. Inspector, media, and colors. And again, where do we just assume we would have pictures?
Media.
So I just click on media. I could have the option of putting in a movie, have the option of putting in photos, or even music. Well, I want to put in a photo. Okay, well, I'm going to go ahead and go to this photo. Now I have that spot highlighted, right? I just grab this photo and just dump it right in. I can show you how to do a PowerPoint too. It's totally whatever you guys want me to do. Honestly, that's what I will do. I'm gearing it like that. That's no problem. So, I was just kind of told, hey, come in, show some I Like Sweet stuff. I didn't mean to like zip through stuff. I'm truly sorry about that. So, I mean, but I want you guys. This is to be geared towards you. That's what I care about.
Can we talk about documents too? Are we going to get to that?
Which documents?
Anything in the documents. I've had a problem for the last 3 months of putting stuff in the trash. It won't go.
No problem.
And that's what I...
We'll do that together then.
Okay.
How about that?
Mm-hmm.
We'll just work on it, me and you. Okay. So, I mean, you can also manipulate these photos anyway. The reason why I told you click on the photo of the stuff that you're doing is because let's say you just want a photo to go on the castle here. Okay, well, I'm going to click off of that. I'm just going to drag this in. You see how it highlights in blue? Perfect. But if you just dump it in, you see it's got its own new image directory. So you can play with that if you want. You can just dump stuff in and do that. That's not a problem.